inside, the 5.0 Mustang. The V8, about 460 horsepower. You can see this is the GT version. Got this sway bar in the front. GT label on the back. Open it up. Look at all that space. It's a very large space for the trunk. These tail lights looking awesome. There's an absolutely gorgeous steering wheel here with the pony right in the middle. Plenty of controls for, this is your cruise control. Up here's your volume for your entertainment. Here's to control the menu. Obviously some more buttons down here for your phone, navigation system, some quick buttons. The paddle shifters behind it, a ton of fun. Here, let's go ahead and turn it on. You can hear it power up. Beautiful gauges here, show the pony. Then we get right into our settings. This version here has the seat warmers and seat coolers for passenger and for driver. This is really cool. I mean, the start button is just an awesome feel, awesome look. Here, these toggle switches are your, a bunch of different settings. So here's obviously your emergency flashers. Here is your traction control. So if I hit the switch, traction control off, on. There's a secret. If you're looking to get completely in race mode, if you hit this button up and hold it for a few seconds, it should advanced track and it'll turn off. And that is a scary way to be driving, I'll tell you that. I've only done that a few times and it's so easy to do a burnout, so easy to lose control. So we're gonna turn that back on. Here, the next button is the steering. So you can control what kind of steering you want to do. If you want the sport steering, the comfort steering, or the normal steering. All those options right there. The next one down is the mode over here. And on that, oh, there's the mode over here. So you can make it a custom mode. There's a sport plus. And you can see the gauges are changing. So in sports plus, that RPM, the tachometer, goes all the way across. If you go to the track mode, you can see again it changes. Give you a really clear idea of your settings there. If you change your shift points, I just turned on the AC, that's why the RPM went up. It's hot. Let's see, mode. You hit it once and it shows which one it is. Here's the drag race mode. Again, the same screen for the tack. Here's our snow and ice. This is what I had last night when I first picked it up. I'm in Denver and it was snowing last night. There we go. Here's just your normal driving mode, driving configuration. And then my mode, which you can change up. Let me show you real quick on the steering wheel. You hit the pony button and you get this my mode. So you can then change a bunch of different features. You can change how the cluster appears. My color is something I've messed around with. So you can change the color on all the dials. So if I have it at red right now, but you can change if you like, oh, let's do the blue. I think that's a pretty good look as well. But I really like the red. But you can see the primary color. You also can do the secondary color, the ambient color. There's lights underneath these door handles. Lights down below by the feet. All of those can be changed, the color and the how bright they are. Or you can do create your own color and, you know, put it exactly the hue and the brightness and all of those that you want. So plenty of things to change around. So there you go. And you can see under my mode, if you just want to go to your quick settings, you can set it up exactly as you want.
So this car has a lot of options electronically. Going back down here, this is a really nice screen. You know, obviously controls for audio, the climate. If you go just to the home, it kind of gives you an overview. It has a map function built in, you know, shows you what's playing, and if you have a phone connected. Here is the control for turning the steering wheel heater on. Also a wonderful feature. There's climate. If you want to see more, you can go here and it'll show you in your control for the steering wheel how you want the air to be blowing. Here, if you have your phone connected, you can do that. Here's the built-in navigation system. It just shows you a map. You can add a location. I haven't experimented with that much. Here's apps. If you have your phone connected, the Apple CarPlay, you know, your phone would show up there, and you could use the apps available on your phone. And then obviously settings. Change around a bunch of different things. Yeah, there you go. Here's the glove box. Nice room there. There's the manual. Some really nice touches. I like these. The air conditioner is great. I didn't have the problem at all that I had at the Camaro with the windshield fogging up. I feel like there's really good visibility. Just a super car. Obviously you have the leather seats. Here, this, to open this convertible top, there's this lever here. You pull down, you twist, and once it's unlocked, then you can do this. The windows you see roll down, and up the top goes. Follow it all the way back. Take a quick look around the car now. All right, so one of the things I wanted to show, because this convertible top is a soft top and it all folds up right here, what you get is you actually don't lose any space in the trunk. While you have the top down, it doesn't make any difference. So under here, you could have room for a spare. This one doesn't have it, but you could put one down there. Walk around with the top down, get a sense. Most cars I don't like the convertible, but this one I feel like it looks beautiful with it on or off. One of the things I want to show is that the back seat, again, this car is meant for two people maximum. You can have some very small people. I'm pretty tall, so I have the seat all the way back, but still it's not much leg room there. Nice switch if you're trying to get in or out the back. Could be that there. Closing up the top now. I can continue. You just hold the button going forward. And then this switch here, the lever, just pull down, rotate, lock it back in place. So let's talk about this car. My three favorite features. Number one, the sound. This car sounds absolutely amazing. How does that sound? Does that not just sound absolutely perfect for a car like this? They've definitely nailed it. I absolutely love that sound. That sound alone makes me want to buy this car. Number two thing that I love about this car is just the feel. They've done a really good job of, between the leather and the metallic, the chrome finish. It's just the combination of it, the look and feel. All the buttons, they feel like a race car. That's something, it doesn't feel cheap. It feels just rough enough, but also
refined enough. There's that balance there, and this car is right where you want it, right where I want it. The third thing I really, really like about this car is the customization. The fact that you can tune it to how you want to drive. So if you just want to cruise, you can get it in that mode and you can cruise. It'll get it over 20 miles a gallon. It'll get probably 22 to 23 miles per gallon. If you're just cruising, obviously if you're hot riding, it'll be closer to 18. That's what I've been getting because I've been on it and off of it. You can customize it between the colors and the feel, the steering, the braking, all of those things. Having that customization, you can really make it your car. Things I don't like about it. I'd say number one is when you're driving this, the fact that there are speed limits makes this car frustrating because it just, especially in the right modes, it wants to go fast. You can hear it wants to go fast. You can feel it. So just the fact that I'm not on an open racetrack, I'd love to take this car out on the open and just see what it can do. Number two, what I don't like about it. I don't think there's anything else I don't like about this car. This is a fantastically built car. I have driven the 2018 model, this exact same one, and the 2019 model. Some slight differences, but honestly, this car is a dream car. It's a dream car for sure. Ooh, one other feature I'm going to have to show you later because of it's better at night. But under the mirrors on this car, there are lights that shine down that give you your own personal parking spot. Just that feature alone also is a, it makes this car very, very special and very desirable. So thanks for watching. And if you want one of these cars, hit that like button, make a comment down below, and we can all join in our desires to want this car. Thanks for watching, and let me know if there's any other cars you want me to do. Thanks. Bye.